الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد My dear elders and brothers, respected ulama ikram, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran reminded us to make tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. Allah said, we will believe, turn towards Allah with sincere tawbatan nasuha. So what is Tawbah? Imam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahmatullahi ta'ala in his book Madarij al-Salikin Al-Madarij al-Salikin, the book of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, he says that Tawbah is the door to Jannah. Tawbah is the first step towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said that Surah al-Fatiha is the Fatiha of Tawbah. And he explains that when the slave, when he is praying salah before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he says, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ, he is making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, do not make me and do not include me among those who have attracted your punishment. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ, do not put me with those people who you have punished, who have attracted your ghadab, who have attracted your anger. وَلَا الضَّالِينَ, and do not put me with those people who have gone astray. What is the meaning of this dua? This dua means that the person who is reciting Al-Fatiha is saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I do not want to be with them, meaning I make tawbah from everything which attracts your anger. And I make tawbah from everything which is misguided. And Imam Ibn al-Qayyim says that a person who recites Al-Fatiha with understanding is making tawbah in every rakat that he is reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. And this is the salah alone, and of course after that whenever you recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the issue of tawbah in the Quran in several places. The first instance of tawbah, as we know, was the tawbah of our father, Adam alayhi salam. When Adam alayhi salam made a mistake, as a result of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him out of the Jannah, and this is the mashia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beholds the creation of Adam alayhi salam itself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa. So it was the intention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send Adam alayhi salam on the earth even before he created Adam alayhi salam. So what is the first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salam when he was sending him out of the Jannah into the earth? The first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salam when he was sending him out of the Jannah into the earth is how to get back into the Jannah. The first thing he taught Adam alayhi salam, the first thing he gave in the hand of Adam alayhi salam was the key to Jannah. And what was the key to Jannah? رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنْفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Tawbah is the key to Jannah. Tawbah is the door of Jannah. We know that the biggest ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us is al-iman. The fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us iman. But in a manner of speaking, tawbah is an even bigger ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because tawbah is the ni'mah without which if one exited iman, there would be no way of going back into iman. Say for example, people like us who are born in Muslim homes. Alhamdulillah, we were born in a Muslim home. We heard the adhan the minute we were born. But the shaitan is with us. And who knows? You know and I know that just like one sentence is required for a person who has been a mushrik or a kafir all his life, for that person to enter into Islam, for all his sins to be forgiven, and for all those sins to be converted into good deeds, what is required? One single sentence. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. خلاص. 100 years of shirk, 100 years of kufr is wiped out and all those sins are converted into hasanat. When the ayah of Surah Al-Furqan, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Yubadilullahu sayyi'ati hasanat, when this ayah was revealed, said, and Umar ibn al-Khattab went around telling people, I am the best of you. So people said, this is, you know, we are all in this race of trying to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you make this statement and claim that you are the best of us? We are all trying to be the best. He said, no, did you not hear what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said? He said, what did Allah say? Allah said this. يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَةً. Allah said that the person who makes tawbah, Allah will convert his sayyi'at into hasanat. Allah will convert his sins into good deeds. So he said, before Islam, I was the worst of you. Nobody committed as many sins as I committed. So now Allah has converted them all into good deeds. So now I am the best of you because I have got this huge stockpile of good deeds. The way the Sahaba understood the Quran, they took it to heart, they took it as real, which is what it is. So the door of Jannah, the key to Jannah is Tawbah. If someone enters Islam, all he needs is one sentence. Similarly, may Allah protect us from that, this tongue of ours. Rasulullah said, guarantee me your tongue and what is between your legs, and I will guarantee you that. This tongue of ours can take us out of Islam very fast. Same one sentence. One sentence of shirk or kufr can take us clean out of Islam. Just like one sentence is required to come into Islam, one sentence is enough to take us out of Islam. Now say for example, may Allah protect us all from this. But say for example, something like this happens. Now what do you do? If there was no tawbah, what would you do? So out of Islam, there is no way to get back. Subhanallah. How does a person who is not a born Muslim, who is born in some other religion, and he sees the beauty of Islam and he said, I want to enter Islam, how does he enter Islam if there was no Tawbah? That is the importance of Tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also showed us the issue of Tawbah in another place. Yunus alayhi salam. Yunus alayhi salam went and preached to his people. And like all the Anbiya, he was rejected. There was no Nabi who was not rejected. Every Nabi had to face this. And so Yunus alayhi salam left. And he left before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had permitted him to leave. And then we know the whole story, and I am always conscious of that clock, so I am not telling you the whole story now. But you know the story where in the boat and he was thrown, or you know, he volunteered to go off into that, and then the fish swallowed him, the whale swallowed him, and then what did he do in the belly of the whale? What did he say? La ilaha illa anta subhana inni kuntu min al-zalimin. So, hear it, O Allah, you are all glory and majesty. Verily, I am the one who has committed this zulm. Inni kuntu min al-zalimin. And that's what we say, all of us in Jalla today, we all will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, La ilaha illa anta subhana inna kunna min al-zalimin. Because wallahi, all of us are zalimun. All of us are zalimun. Why? I am not saying deliberately we are doing something haram. Inshallah, we are not doing anything deliberate. But zulm is not to give somebody his haq. What is the definition of zulm? Oppression. What is oppression? Oppression is not to give somebody his right. And who is the number one whose right we are supposed to fulfill? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can we say, can any of us say, certainly I can't say for myself, can we say that there is even one single action in my entire life which I can say, Ya Rabbi, this action which I have done fulfills your rights? Can I say this? Can anybody on the face of the earth say? If somebody could say, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could say. But what do we know about Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, make tawbah to Allah, return to Allah. I make tawbah 70 times in a day. For someone whose position we know, for someone who was forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, I ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 70 times a day. And another hadith, the Sahaba said he used to count, and we counted up to 100. Where Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to make Tawbah to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, to return to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So we know that it is not necessary to commit a sin in order to make Tawbah. Tawbah is ubudiyah. Tawbah is the sign that I am the slave of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So we make Tawbah to return to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, to show and to testify to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala every minute of our life, to say, Ya Rabbi, I am your slave. I am your abd. And you are my Rabb, and there is no one in between, and I do not make shirk. And I do not make ubudiyah to anyone other than you. There is no one. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. So to enter into Jannah, tawbah. When you are in personal difficulty, tawbah. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. What about when there is collective difficulty? What about collective difficulty? Nuh alayhi salam, preaching to his people 950 years. Imagine, these are the stories of the Quran. It is our iman, it is our aqeedah, that 950 is not a figurative speech, it is actual number. Can you imagine, today we talk about da'wah, we talk about tabligh, we talk about doing the work of Islam and so on and so forth. 950. Inni da'awtu qawmi laylaw wa nahara, 24 hours. He said, Ya Rabbi, I'm giving da'wah to myself day and night. The Anbiya did not do the work of da'wah part-time. They did not do the work of da'wah so many days in a year. They did not do the work of... This is all because of our weakness. This is because of our weakness, and it's because we also have to go in the path of Allah to learn how to do the work. So therefore there is a course. There is a course in 6 times, like you go for anything else. You go and study medicine and engineering and so on, and nobody asks, why should it be 5 years, why should it not be 7 years? There is a course. But what is the purpose? The doctor who is studying medicine for 5 years is not giving up medicine at the end of 5 years. He is studying medicine for 5 years to practice medicine for the rest of his life. At least we don't think. We just make, you know, people have a habit of making comments and upgrading objections. What is the work of da'wah? What is the work of tabligh? It is to be done by whom, for how long? It is to be done, it's a fard ayn, the personal fard on every single Muslim man or woman, to be done for their entire life until the day they die. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take us and take our soul in His path, inshallah. To learn that, we go somewhere. So what did Nuh alayhi salam talk about? I'm talking about tawbah as a means of deliverance from collective problems. Nuh alayhi salam giving da'wah to his people. Da'wah to qawmi layla wa nahara. I call them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. Then as a result of their rejection and rejection and rejection, musibah comes on them, difficulties comes on them, trials and tribulations come on them, because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also told us. What is the reason for trials and tribulations and difficulties coming on us? What is the reason? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? He said, زَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِينَا. He said the trials and tribulations, the difficulties, the musibah, the problems of the dunya and the problems on the sea and the land are because of the deeds of people which come out from their hands. بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِينَا. And why do these difficulties come? لِيُذِقَهُ بَعْدَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that we can give them a taste of the result of these deeds, so that they will turn towards us. وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَّ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. In another place, Surah Nisa, Allah said, we give them a taste of a small punishment before the big punishment, so that they turn towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and save themselves from the big punishment. Tawbah. So what do the people of Nuh alayhi salam, what do they go and they tell him what? They tell him, these are our problems. Nuh alayhi salam says, this is what I was warning you against. So what does he say? What does he tell them to do? فقولوا استغفروا ربكم.